A marriage may be in fact invalid, but officially it is not declared invalid. Officially it is not dissolved. In such a case also parties are not free. No, before God I know my marriage is invalid. Please bless my second marriage. Somebody brings a girl. My first marriage. Can we accept it?
No.
It may be true also. But go to the tribunal, man. Apply to the Pope, man. We have to say it. You understand now? That point. That's why this point also many people do not know. Invalid means, invalid may be in conscience. For that matter, so many marriages may be invalid only. Because the girls are forced. They don't come afterwards. After all, I have slept with that man. Why to go for it? Invalidity, non-declaration like that. So marriage enjoys the favor of law till the people come and say the marriages are considered valid. Till the marriage is declared invalid, they are not free to marry. Okay? We go to the next one. Impediment of disparity of cult. It is called, the fourth impediment, is called the impediment of disparity of cult. Disparity of cult. Disparity of cult. Of cult. So, this is a marriage between a Catholic and a unbaptized person. Unbaptized person. A Catholic marries an unbaptized person while the unbaptized person wants to remain unbaptized. When he wants to be baptized and become Catholic, then it will be a sacramental marriage, no problem. It will become marriage between two Catholics. The unbaptized person. So, we have also what is known as mixed marriage. A Catholic marries a baptized person who is non-Catholic. Baptized non-Catholic. Strictly speaking, it is called the mixed marriage. Sometimes we use mixed marriage means even disparity of cult we include. But we have to distinguish between both. What is a disparity of cult marriage? What is a mixed marriage? This is also mixed only. But we specifically call it disparity of cult marriage. Cult is worship. Disparity of cult marriage. So, in principle, marriage with an unbaptized makes the marriage invalid. Marriage with an unbaptized person makes a marriage invalid. Marriage with an unbaptized. But, subject to certain conditions. Subject to certain conditions. A dispensation can be obtained in accordance with Canon 1025. The conditions can be fulfilled. The conditions are valid. In principle, marriage, mixed marriage, is valid but unlawful. Mixed marriage or unlawful. For mixed marriage, you need permission. For disparity of cult marriage, we call it dispensation. You need dispensation. Only after the permission, it will be lawful valid and lawful. Without permission, valid but unlawful. Without permission, it will be valid but unlawful. In mixed marriage. Mixed marriage is marriage between a Catholic and a baptized non-Catholic. Here, marriage between a Catholic and an unbaptized person. You need a dispensation. In both cases, what is mentioned in 1125 for mixed marriage, those conditions has to be observed. Now we examine the wordings of the canon and other points that are mentioned there. A marriage is invalid. Look at the canon very carefully. When one of the two persons was baptized in the Catholic Church or received into it, and the other was not baptized. The other words in the canon must be put in bracket, they are deleted now. So, start with the, and as not by a formal act defected from it, must be deleted. Because the canon law has been changed. And as not by a formal act, is it there, at least put in bracket or underline it in your book. Put within bracket. Now no more this expression is not there. So, what is the present canon is this. I read again. A marriage is invalid when one of the two persons was baptized in the Catholic Church or received into it. Then come to the last line, third line, last part, and the other was not baptized. That's what is the present canon.
That part
is delete. Delete or at least put in a bracket. Bracket that is omitted. So that part was changed, look at the end of the book, appendix, some changes in the code, there 1086 para 1 is given at the end of the book appendix. At the end of the book, do you see, canon 1086 is changed. So those words are received into it and the other was not baptized. Formally, only if the person has by a formal act defected from the church, he is not bound by this law. Now it is very clear, once Catholic, you are always, even if you go away, you are always bound by canon law. That's why it was changed by Pope Benedict. So now you understand, see, why the code uses, you are baptized in the Catholic Church. Second one is baptized in the non-Catholic Church, but received into it. How you are receiving a non-Catholic when he wants to become a Catholic? How does a non-Catholic become a Catholic? By the profession of faith. Do you repeat the baptism?
No.
No. Baptism is valid. Once baptized, you are always baptized. Yes. Is valid. Okay, that's why both expressions. So this law affects all those who are baptized Catholics, all those who became Catholics later on from other churches, and it is such a person, if he marries an unbaptized, the marriage is invalid. I already told you, in some situations a Catholic may be allowed to marry a non-Catholic, provided there are some conditions in accordance with 1125. Take note of it, we will come to that later on, when such a dispensation can be given. Now we go to para 2. This impediment is not to be dispensed unless the conditions mentioned in 1125, 1126 have been fulfilled. So, can a dispensation be given? Can be given. But follow the conditions. What are the conditions? 1125, 1126. We will see elaborately. These conditions must be observed both for dispensation and also for permission. So, there is a declaration, there is a promise. there is a teaching, there is an information. What is the declaration? I will not defect from the Catholic faith. Catholic party says. What is the promise? I will bring up the children in the Catholic faith. Declaration and a promise. Declaration that he will not depart. Promise to bring up the children. Then this promise must be informed to the other party. Other party does not make any declaration. Other party says, I know that Catholic party has made this declaration and the promise. Information to the other party. Formerly, non-Catholic party also must promise. Now we don't insist. It is his freedom. Then both parties must be given the catechism on Christian understanding of marriage. Otherwise, he may believe in divorce. He may believe in many wives. Both parties, even though the other party, must be given understanding of Christian marriage.
At the time of marriage, Father,
yeah.
When the party is telling that I will raise my children in Christian faith,
yeah.
But and the opposite party, since they are not bound, we leave them free. But once children grow, the opposite party wants the children to be
inside. Yeah, what to do? The opposite party, that's why the canon says, I will do all in my power. All in my power, can it be interpreted as breaking the marriage? We don't want her to break the marriage. Try her level best, that's all. What happens afterwards is a pastoral problem. The Catholic party must try in her own way. That's all. What we can say, he doesn't affect.
The one who is in Catholic side, is he to be held responsible for that order?
No. Before that itself, you have to see. After marriage, nothing. You have to ensure everything. Responsible for the other party, you can't never be responsible for the other party.
Because see, at the time of marriage, when she has kept a promise,
yes.
Now she is answerable to the church.
Yeah.
So is
answerable means what she says. I will not become a non-Catholic. Secondly, I will try my level best. I tried my level best. My husband not allowing. She promises that she will try her level best. That's all.
No implication.
What can we say? We don't want her to die. Her right to life is more important. Yeah, that's what. We should not be more strict than Jesus himself. Huh? Okay.
But is it a promise or we have to get a return letter?
Yeah, they have to sign. The Catholic party. And the non-Catholic party should know. Should sign if at all needed that he knows that the person has made a promise. Before marriage, in good time, the canon uses the word in good time. Good time means not after the marriage. Then he will say, no, had I known that I would not have married. Very good.
And the marriage also should be celebrated outside the Eucharist.
Yeah, outside. That celebration, we will come to that regarding mixed marriage. Only then the condition have to be fulfilled. We will take up 11:25, 26 later on. Okay, if at the time the marriage was contracted, one party was commonly understood to be baptized, or if his or her baptism was doubtful, the validity of the marriage is to be presumed. In accordance with Canon 1060, marriage enjoys the favor of law. We think they are baptized. Or if the baptism is doubtful, means in both cases we always presume the validity. Only afterwards it is proved that the baptism was never received, or baptism received but it is invalid baptism. Registry doesn't matter. Whether fact of baptism and validity of the baptism are important. Fact of baptism and validity of the baptism. If it is proved, then the marriage will be invalid. Otherwise, we always presume the validity of the marriage. Is it clear? Yeah. Same thing, because 1060 says marriage enjoys the favor of law. We always presume. Somebody thinks he received baptism and marriage. We think that the marriage also is valid. Afterwards it is proved, no baptism at all. Somebody else received baptism. It was not valid baptism. Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Instead of that, Saint Anthony, Sebastian, and Saint George. No, invalid baptism. Or TV, video, mobile, invalid baptism. The baptismal formula. I baptize you. Instead of water, you poured petrol and baptized. Invalid baptism. Invalid baptism. If the baptism is invalid, or if the baptism was never given at all, then the, if it is proved, then the marriage will become invalid.
Yeah. If the baptized person has a problem with their, his partner, so who is in other faith, they are fight, and then he wants to come back to the church, and then he wants to be married.
Already they are in the church only, no? So now, in the disparity of cult marriage, when there is problem, what to do? You have to see any marriage can be invalid only on three grounds. So, consent, you first give the consent, impediment, canonical form. Canonical form, all priest only celebrated, and there was impediment but dispensed. So, no problem, that side also. That is the first one, the consent is there. So, everything was there, it is valid. So, you cannot go for nullity. You cannot go to our tribunal to declare the marriage as invalid. But there is other possibility, because that marriage is non-sacramental. Because one party is not baptized. You can appeal to the Holy Father, apply to the Holy Father for dissolving the marriage in order to marry a Catholic. That is called Petrine privilege. Petrine privilege. By Petrine privilege, the Holy Father can dissolve, not declare invalid. Invalidity only these three grounds. Invalidity only these three grounds. Can dissolve a valid non-sacramental marriage. Or if they are not consummated, then also you can apply to the Holy Father.
In that case, one of the partner is a Christian.
Yeah.
The ritual which is performed is a sacrament for at least one person.
No, no. Again, go back to that point. I told a number of times very clearly. Only when both are baptized, it cannot be sacrament for one and non-sacrament for another. Only when both are baptized. No compromise.
Now when they are separating, okay, Father, but in, okay, their normal life, they are coming to the church normally. In that case, it remains as a, there also it is not a sacrament.
No. Sacrament doesn't depend on they are coming to the church. But there is another problem. Two people baptized, they don't believe. Is it a sacrament? They don't come to the church. Married in the church, like the politician who comes to meet the people every 5 years, they come. Is it a sacrament? It is a big theological question. Canonical question, I will say, Father Ayurveda will say, it is sacrament. That's the faith of the people. That's why in Amoris Laetitia, so people who don't have faith, how strong is their sacramental bond? They were baptized as children, they were brought to the church on the day of marriage, never again coming to the church, they separated. So now such marriages can be considered for invalidity more easily, like that they are saying. But disputed question. Okay. I understand. I am very happy that you are asking this question, because it's clear. On no ground, so one party it is sacrament, another party it is sacrament. Honestly, even though I studied canon law, as a young priest also, I was thinking every marriage between baptized is a sacrament. Every marriage, every valid marriage only is sacrament. If two people marry civilly also, I was also thinking that it was sacrament. Now that I am teaching Kerala, I am telling like that. Though I studied and all, got first rank and all in BTH. But then I was also thinking that every marriage is sacrament. Not every marriage is sacrament. Every valid marriage between two baptized is sacrament. And then many priests are thinking wrongly that a valid marriage between two Protestants is not a sacrament. And some are thinking that you have to bless the marriage again. No, not at all. Only invalid marriage you have to bless again. Two Hindus marry accordingly when they give baptism. When they get baptism, automatically it becomes sacramental marriage. You don't bless their marriage once again. This mistake even canonists are doing. One canonist with doctorate, he says, Father, but then what to enter, Father, in the marriage register? Nothing to do. You cannot give marriage certificate. Marriage is over 10 years ago. Now they became Catholics. It becomes, you can write in the baptism register, on such and such a day, they received baptism, it became sacramental. Yeah, no. That's all. You cannot bless the marriage of two Hindus who are already husband and wife. Otherwise, it is undermining them, saying that they were in invalid marriage or unlawful marriage. No. Like that, when two Protestants, already sacramental marriage, they made profession of faith, that's all you can write.
In case someone has their marriage certificate.
You cannot give. Only you can give marriage certificate only for people whose marriage you bless. Not somebody's marriage you can bless. You cannot give. That's why even canonists make this stupid. Some of the canonists with doctor, they do it. There is a sentence in Amoris Laetitia, you should not bless the marriage again. Rectification, I told you, the other day I was arguing with one canon lawyer. No, he said, Father, we have to rectify. No, rectify means make correct. What was incorrect, man? I asked him. Then he kept quiet. What is already correct, you should not correct. So, that's all we have to understand. So, very important.
Father, what about in this case when a boy is Catholic and a girl is Hindu and they love each other and they want to get married. And both the side of the family members, they are not accepted.
Yeah.
But they want to by all means get married.
Yeah.
Engaged, and then they want to get married.
No problem. No problem on our part we can do, but only that you have to see to get their consent. Other problems, societal problems, all that you have to see. Then you have to see they must be adults. Sometimes it might happen, you get an affidavit that the adult person is coming freely. Otherwise they may find fault with you or converting this and that. So now you have to ensure all this, even to give baptism, in some cases marriage. When there is opposition from the family, civil precautions you have to take. Civilly you should not be faulted. If there is an RSS, they will say, the girl has been out of conversion, they are marrying my girl, all this. All that you have to do. I have no answer. On my part, is the marriage valid? Invalid. If without dispensation means it is invalid. Dispensation should be given according to the condition and the promise. The person must be civilly free. The person is civilly free.
So after the marriage, they want to come back to the Catholic Church and baptize the
No, who married? Why you are saying come back? Already they came to Catholic Church and married, no? Why do you say come back? Come back means one of the parties wants to become a Catholic.
Yeah, she wanted to get baptized.
Baptized, yes. She can. Then it will become sacramental marriage. No need of blessing. Again, another marriage. Already priest only. Bless the marriage. Yeah, good. So after the marriage, if one of the parties wants to become, that day it becomes a sacramental marriage.
What are the documents that we need to produce civilly for a baptism of an adult?
Of an adult, only the affidavit. We did not produce. They have to give. I mean, on our part, we have to require some places, not in every place. Where you think, you know, that. We have to ensure that the person is coming freely to baptize. And in situations where there will be problem of conversion, forced conversion.
Then what is that document?
No, affidavit they call it. No?
What is that freedom?
Yeah, that is an undertaking given by the person that he is coming freely with witnesses according to the formalities of civil. Okay. What is time? No, which can we saw last?
86.
The next canon is very simple, very very simple. Those who are in sacred orders invalidly attempt marriage. So now you can marry. Final permission over 30 years, sir?
Yes.
When?
Last month.
Last month already. Second year is not over. Okay. Now 3 years also will be covered by next canon, then 88. Now second years can validly marry. Second years can validly marry. Deacons are covered by this canon. Deacons are who are those in sacred orders? Deacons, presbyters, bishops. That is next canon, you don't worry. This canon, 1087, says those who are in sacred orders, those who are in sacred orders, invalidly attempt to marriage. So the lawgiver doesn't want to say invalidly marry also. They are only attempting to marry. Father, they have children and all, father, still they have only attempted. So the law always uses the word attempt to marriage. For an invalid marriage, it always says attempted marriage. Attempt marriage. Attempt means they may have children, but still they have only attempted marriage. Who are in sacred orders? Deacons, priests, bishops. Can it be dispensed?
Yes.
Can it be dispensed? Can the bishops be dispensed?
Yes.
Their
office, they can be dispensed.
Who can dispense? Can the Pope be dispensed and allowed to marry?